for me, what makes Strictly special is just, it reminds me of a certain time of year, the kids watch it, we look forward to our Saturday nights. It's just great entertainment. I think anybody, whether you're a dancing fan or not, I think there's something for everybody. Coming from a world where performance is what you do, and it's been a long time since I've been able to perform, so I think this is most probably my last chance of getting out there and remembering what I loved to do when I was younger. It doesn't take a lot to get me up at a party. I'm always like the first one on the dance floor, normally dragging a husband that's very against dancing, then please let me sit down. But I love anything. I love a good beat. I love a bit of Motown. I do love a bit of hip hop. anything with a good bass line I normally like. Will I be able to do a dirty bass dance? Never know. Obviously done the music video kind of dancing, but actually to learn something really particular that has to be done in a certain way, I'm really looking forward to having the opportunity to learn to do something properly. I don't really get much flesh out. I'm pretty standard jeans and t-shirt kind of girl. So the sequins are making me nervous, but I'm sure as time goes on, I'll love the sequins more and more. Any mum out there knows that when you have children, you lose a little bit of your own career and your own life, what you did before. And I think now I feel like I've sort of earned a little bit of time back, and to go out there and sort of just remember doing what I love. I loved watching Sophie Ellis-Bextor in Strictly. I think she always just seemed so graceful and kept herself as we know her, as we've seen her in everything else she's done. And Frankie Bridge, who's a good friend, and I loved watching her as well, knowing her and seeing her get better and better. I just need a partner that's kind of kind and quite nice. As long as they're there, then I'm on the side.